growing up in their household on that farm in Millisport, my brother and I may have had a vague awareness that John and Lena Bush were not my mother's real parents. Beyond that, we wouldn't know. And in the way of family reticence, which is a kind of dignity, we could not ask, any more than children of that year would have boldly asked their fathers what their incomes were and their mothers whether they really wanted children. But here is a surprise. My mother's account of the traumatic time in her early life did not center upon the murder of her father, whom she had not known. After all, she'd been an infant. But the mortifying fact of having been, quote, given away. When for a special feature in Oprah Magazine in the late 1990s, several women writers were commissioned to interview their own mothers, I learned some of this old, sad story, still upsetting to my mother so many decades later. All my mother seemed to know was, actually I called her on the telephone so that I could interview her without my father being there because he was so dominant that she could never really talk openly without my father kind of interrupting. Anyway, we talked on the telephone and suddenly she started telling me things that I had never known. And all she could say really repeatedly was that her mother had given her away. She said, my mother didn't want me. I used to cry and cry. And she started crying then. I was stricken to the heart. My mother was 80 years old. And this trauma of 1917 was as recent and fresh to her as if no time had intervened. Of all the relatives on both sides of our family, my mother Carolina had the reputation to be the most generous, the most kind, the warmest and sunniest. I didn't want to think that in her innermost heart, Mommy thought of herself as a child whose mother had not wanted her. Crimes reverberate through many years and through many lives. It is a rare homicide that destroys only one person. And it is a paradox to accept that had a Hungarian immigrant not been murdered in 1917, I would not be alive today. How many of us, many more than would wish to speak of so sordid a fact, or are burst to the permanent, premature deaths of others whom we've never known, but to whom we are linked by that mysterious shared fate called blood. Here's the ironic equipoise of which Henry James wrote, this catastrophe that was for my mother through her life, a source of acute sorrow and shame, was for me, her daughter, the very genesis of my life.